Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. On March 21st, President Trump signed the National Aeronautics and Space Administration Transition Authorization Act of 2017. The bipartisan legislation reaffirms Congress's commitment to the agency and directs it to pursue a balanced portfolio for space exploration and space science, including continued development of the Space Launch System, Orion and Commercial Crew Program, space and planetary science missions, such as the James Webb Space Telescope, Wide Field Infrared Survey Telescope, and Europa mission, and ongoing operations of the International Space Station and Commercial Resupply Services Program. In a statement, Acting NASA Administrator Robert Lightfoot, who attended the signing along with two astronauts and members of Congress, thanked the President and Congress for supporting the agency and its mission. On March 24th, NASA's Shane Kimbrough and Tomas Pesquet of ESA conducted the first in a series of three planned spacewalks outside the International Space Station to prepare it for the future arrival of U.S. Commercial Crew spacecraft and upgrade station hardware. This spacewalk included work to prepare for installation of a docking port for future Commercial Crew vehicles, maintenance on the station's Canadarm2 robotic arm, inspection of a radiator, and replacement of several cameras. The two remaining spacewalks in the series are targeted in the next couple of weeks. On March 19th, the SpaceX Dragon cargo spacecraft was unberthed and released from the space station almost a month after delivering nearly 5,500 pounds of supplies to the station. Hours later, the Dragon splashed down safely in the Pacific Ocean about 200 miles southwest of Long Beach, California. It brought back a variety of experiments, the results of which could help researchers develop better medical treatments for humans on Earth and in space. This was the company's 10th contracted cargo resupply mission to the International Space Station for NASA. NASA astronaut Jeff Williams, who returned to Earth last September from the space station, made several appearances in the Washington area the week of March 20th. Williams shared experiences from his mission during a video presentation March 23rd at the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum in Washington. And earlier in the week, he presented NASA's Silver Snoopy Award to Information Technology Specialist Anne Marie Keim at NASA headquarters. Astronauts present the award to recognize employees for their outstanding performance and contribution to flight safety and mission success. On March 23rd, NASA's Associate Administrator for Space Technology, Steve Jurczyk, and Ames Research Center Director Eugene Tu visited Bally Ribbon Mills in Bally, Pennsylvania. A tour of the company's facility included a first-hand look at work being done on a new advanced woven thermal protection system being developed for potential NASA planetary exploration missions. NASA scientists discussed findings and perspectives on a range of topics during the 48th Lunar and Planetary Science Conference, March 20th through 24th near Houston. Several NASA briefings were held, during which representatives from the agency's Planetary Science Division updated the community on the status of NASA's fleet of planetary missions and programs. The annual event brings together international specialists to present the latest results of research in planetary science. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twar.